Diwali week, and as usual, it's time for us to serve up some crackers on the Auto Car Show. Each year, we take some of our favorite cars over the year with the fastest Indian to the Sri Perumbudur track and let him have a blast. Over the years, we formed a leaderboard of the fastest cars tested in consistent conditions by the same driver. Take a look at the top 10. Can the name at the top change this year? Well, let's see. It's quite a lineup once again, from the small and sturdy to the big and bold, and it stretches across segments. Yes, of course, we don't expect the Honda City to take on the GTR and be ahead on the leaderboard, but each time out on the track, it's more a reference point of how much cars have improved over the years and how much the segment improves. But obviously, we have to have some fun too, so we do look for the fastest car on the track. It may look like any other year, but of course, as usual, the cars are always different. And Naren, today the conditions are also a bit different. I mean, the track is a bit damp. Is that going to affect the timings?
Yeah, certainly. We've never had conditions like this. So, it might affect it a little bit on the lap times, but I wouldn't say it's going to be a big difference to the... It's almost right. It's damp in some corners, in the apex of the corners, but I think it should be okay.
Well, the fastest car here has been the GTR. Do you think anything here is going to be able to shatter that timing?
Well, not as fast as the GTR. I wouldn't think any car is going to be shattering times today. One, because it's damp, the circuit. And two, I mean, the GTR is a special car for the track. But we have some exciting cars here. The Jaguar F-Type R, the Cayman S, the new M6. And a lot more cars which may get closer to the GTR time. Let's see.
Which do you think is the pick of the bunch? Let's see if you get it right before we come to the results.
Well, I would say the F-Type R is going to be the fastest, followed by the Cayman S, and then the M6, I would think. But I could be wrong. Let's see.
Well, the F-Type R is a great fun car to drive. Track may be all about clean driving, but this is a car that likes to get its tail out quite a bit. So you think you're going to have a lot of fun with it?
Yeah, definitely. A lot of fun. This car looks the part, sounds really nice as well. And you can get those black smokies, you know, black lines going, and a lot of smoke.
Well, it's not really a very hot day here, but you're going to have some scorching action on that track. Let's go. The Honda City has always been a topper in its segment. And with the new City, it got a second wind by adding a diesel power plant to the lineup. However, for our track day, we decided on Honda's refined, fun-to-drive petrol 1.5 VTEC. Though the new City got the same 1.5 VTEC as before, a new intake manifold to better the bottom end response and a redesigned cooling system to warm up the engine faster made it quite different to drive. It's always been an engine we've enjoyed, free revving in its nature and very refined. Let's see what Naren thought of the improvements.
The VTEC engine is obviously a big plus point to all Honda cars, and this is the same. Very, very strong rev to 7000 RPM. The NVH is quite loud, but the engine noise is quite nice, so I kind of like it. Only thing I didn't like was the feel of the steering wheel. It's too light in even at high speed, where you would really like a little bit firmer feel.
The suspension of the City also got tweaks, and with added meat to the front roll bar and a stiffer setup, Naren could push harder around the corners, resulting in a time which was 2.0 seconds faster than the last generation City, which is quite a huge margin.
It's certainly quicker than the older City by a good 2 seconds a lap, which is quite a big step. So the handling characteristics have improved a lot, but the thing is, it can put the power down without losing much traction. And in front wheel drive cars, because it's quite soft and rolly, what tends to happen is a lot of inner wheel spin, which is much less. It's quite soft, obviously, because for our Indian road conditions, I think this is how it should be. Not good for the track, but good for the road.
The Octavia, another trusted steed. When the Octavia first launched in India, it was a hit with its fun-to-drive spirit, great dynamics and sturdy build. The new Octavia comes with the same characteristics, but with its longer wheelbase and wider track, it allowed Narain to attack the corners around the track.
The way it handles for a front wheel drive car, it's quite phenomenal actually. Yeah, it's quite impressive. It has some very clever electronics. So even though it doesn't let you have a lot of fun, it's kind of quick on the track.
The turbo petrol has always been quick. And with an additional 18 bhp of power and 70 kilograms of weight shedding, it's become a little quicker. The additional power, lighter weight and amazing stability around the corners allowed Narain to clock a time of 2 minute 10.75 seconds.
It's a second quicker than the old the Laura RS. So yeah, they've done a good job. And again, the lap time could be faster. The limiting factor could be the tyres. It's quite narrow and less grip. Strong engine. Yeah, good braking, everything. All the stability, everything, they've done a fantastic job.
Here's a car that you can be happy just feasting your eyes on. But that AMG moniker on the back is the one that hints at the fun that can be had behind the wheel. A four-wheel drive AMG with a four-cylinder turbocharged petrol? Well, that has to be fun.
This car behaves a little bit like a front-wheel drive car. Obviously, it has a four-wheel drive system, which is pretty clever. And whenever you lose traction, I think the power is transferred more to the front, so the understeer.
335 bhp and 45.9 kgm being churned out of a 2-litre turbo petrol with just 1650 kilos of curb weight means tremendous performance. And the strong mid-range of this engine allowed Narain to really enjoy some action around the track. But he expected just a little more of the drama that comes with the AMG tag.
Well, it was quite fast on the track. It did a 2 minute flat. So compared to other benchmarks, I think it's done a reasonable time. Yeah, I think the negative things would be just doesn't sound very nice. We've been used to grunty, AMG cars before. It doesn't just gel with the AMG badge, you know what I mean. And obviously, they do have to be really brutal to get the car to oversteer, and not as much fun as the rear wheel drive cars, AMG cars, which are fun to drive and a lot of sliding and so on.
Well, it's just three cars down and we're already at the 2 minute lap time barrier. Coming up after this break is a set of more extreme Germans, so watch out for all the action. Well, as we saw, the CLA 45 AMG definitely impressed Narain around the track. But he's got another fast four-door coming up to drive, the Audi S6. It's real quick. Let's see how it does. If you want sporty performance without having to give up the practicality of a four-door saloon that offers all the luxury bells and whistles, then the S6 offers up just that. The best of both worlds. And testimony to that fact is the blast that Narain had with it on the track.
I think it's a tremendous car. It's you have a good feeling driving this car on the track. A little bit rolly, but it's not the full-blown RS version of the Audi. So you can't expect it to be that sporty. Only thing is that a few other things which were obviously built into the car. I think more a safety aspect is the understeer. It's you have to provoke it to oversteer, and also it has some clever electronics again with this car. So once it stabilizes, it feels a little bit like a rear wheel drive car. It doesn't let you drift, but it you have that feeling that it's gonna, but then it's you already passed the you're already on the straight line by then. So it's very, very clever, the system.
He may not have got it fully sideways as he would have liked, but he definitely enjoyed the punchy 4-litre V8. 414 bhp and a whopping 56.08 kgm of torque? Not bad for a car you can drive to work every day, what say?
It has a tremendous engine, I would say. It has a lot of torque and a lot of comforts in the car. On the track, I think it's done 2 minutes one, which is which is quite good for this kind of a car and for the weight and for, I mean, as I said, it's very, very comfortable inside and lots of luxuries and you can't ask for any better performance on the track with this kind of a car. And yeah, the negative things would be a little bit too much understeer, and they should make these cars a little bit more fun to drive because you're already in the sport line of Audi, so they should make it a little bit more fun.
Well, to Naren, I guess everything after an F1 seems a little less fun, but the next car is surely going to bring a smile to his face. I drove this car, I couldn't wipe the smile off my face. The RS7 is not only a hot looking car, but it offers up some smoking performance too. The kind of manic torque that pins you to the back of your seat comes with an equal balance of practicality in the form of yet another four-door luxury sports saloon from Audi.
Well, it's a fun car to drive, yes. It has predominantly it's an understeery car because of the four-wheel drive system, but then it does oversteer a bit if you want it to and if you provoke it. So quite easy to drive, well balanced. Just the mass, the weight of the car is so much that it just spoils the fun on the track a little bit. But it's a pretty stiff car. I was expecting a better lap time, but that's not the case. And then it's again with all these cars, you have just one lap and they get too hot in the Chennai temperature, and I don't think they're meant for the track, to be honest.
So the 553 bhp V8 that puts out a stonking 71.3 kgm of torque protested the Chennai heat and Naren pushing it to its limits around the track. But even that couldn't take away from Naren's enthusiasm about the way it put its power down. The only thing letting it down, however, was the almost 2-ton of weight that it carries around.
The car is certainly faster on the track, lap time wise, it's about 2 and a bit seconds faster. But I was expecting more performance, not performance, I was expecting a better lap time on the track. But the thing is, it's so heavy, the car, and we're losing a lot of time in the, you know, getting in and out of the corners. Because you feel the weight transfer and then it loads up the front and then it just washes out. But I mean, the engine is phenomenal, it's so strong all the way. And has a lot of grunt.
Well, with Audi churning out four-door practicality packed with performance, BMW can never really be far behind. Or will it be ahead? Well, the BMW M6 Grand Coupe is a stylish four-door packed with luxury goodies and a snorting V8 under the hood. It churns out 552 bhp and 69.3 kgm of torque. Close enough to take on the competition.
The BMW M cars are a lot of fun to drive, and this one is the same. It's a rear-wheel drive car, so yes, it kind of lets you slide and have a lot of fun. Compared to the M5, which I drove here last, was this car gives you more confidence. It's more planted on the ground. Only thing, I think it might be a little bit heavier than the other car, the M5. So, I really like everything on this car. No dislikes really. And it was quicker than the RS7 as well by over half a second, which is what we expected. And it feels really lot of confidence when you drive the car, and it doesn't catch you by surprise. So yeah, and the gearbox on the sport mode is quite fast on the upshifts and the downshifts. Overall, I like this car so far the best.
When Naren felt a little disappointed by the RS7 in the way it transferred its weight around the corners, he came away smiling about the M6 Grand Coupe. And of course, the visuals will let you see why. This rear-wheel drive car was happy to get its tail out and allow Naren to have a little fun that he'd been missing out on. Even with all that action, he managed a 1 minute 59.45 second on the track. Well, that German brigade definitely stirred up the action. But of course, we have hotter stuff coming up for you right after this break. Welcome back, and chuck those remotes away. You're not going to want to go anywhere, because I've driven the F-Type Coupe R and I'm telling you, there's going to be a lot of sideways action coming up. But before the F-Type, Naren was eager to get into this hot stepper. Now, Porsches are known for their dynamics, so the Cayman was bound to be a delight around the track. And needless to say, this mid-engined, playful thoroughbred scorched the track.
Well, it doesn't have a lot of power from the engine, so on the straight line, it's quite slow. So we were making up times in the corners. Nevertheless, it didn't shatter the lap timing here. We did a 1 minute 58 second lap, which is okay. But compared to the 911 Carrera 4S we drove last time, it's a good 4.5 seconds slower. Which I thought would be closer, less of a gap, but it's a it's a beautiful handling car nevertheless. I just need a bit more power top end, and also the when you put the power down, you need to wait and there's nothing happening. So, but as I said, still a lot of fun to drive. I think the rear tires are pretty short because we didn't have any grip whatsoever. Normally these cars handle a bit better. Still Porsche engineering, they know what they're doing, and they make good performance cars, and this is one of them, good car.
Where the power fell short, the brilliant dynamics made up. And Naren scored it really high on the way it brakes, steers and handles.
I think the best part of the car is the way it handles, and the way you can carry the speed to the apex from the braking. Braking is phenomenally good as well, and they have big calipers and big rotors as well. So the stopping power is excellent, and the flat six engine noise is something unique, and I really like it.
Arguably one of the best sports cars in the world, the Cayman S felt brilliantly suited to the track, and it could have been a topper had the straight line power been a little stronger. However, Jaguar's sexy cat, the F-Type Coupe, which has quickly been earning accolades world over, was biting at the bit, ready to be let loose. A stunning looking car, no doubt, but can it conquer the track?
Compared to the XKRS, it's a huge step forward, yes. And compared to these other cars, I think so far we've had most fun in this car. And in terms of lap times, in terms of drivability, and the fun factor is right up there with anything else.
The F-Type Coupe for our track test was the V8 552 bhp version. 1.9 crore worth of car with the best power to weight ratio of the entire bunch tested today. 329 bhp per ton, thanks to its lightweight aluminium construction. Well, that definitely helped the F-Type's track performance. But all the power and dynamics also came with the sound and drama needed for thrill factor. The F-Type topped the day's chart with a 1 minute 56.95 seconds, making it almost 2 seconds faster than the second place Cayman S.
It's the most fun car to drive ever, I think, and it sounds nice and it really looks the part as well. It's so easy to get it sideways, and you don't have to have tremendous car control, you don't need to be a rally driver, racing driver, whatever, Normal people can drive it, sideways and still, get away with it. It's so predictable, so easy to control, and I just love it. It has lots of grunt, obviously, and it's a big step up from the XKRS which we drove on the track here. So the handling characteristics of they've refined it a lot, and it's much tighter, it's easier to drive, and it puts down the power much better, and you know, you can carry the momentum through the corner as well. So the lap time's obviously faster than the XKRS by a long way. And only the disappointing thing was this particular car, they had a bad set of tires, so we could do only one flying lap, and they finished completely destroyed. So you know, the lap times would have been quicker by a second almost. So that's that.
Well, another great track day over here. Some scorching action as we've seen, and the weather also was a bit scorching today. We didn't expect it to be so hot. It was wet in the morning, but the track dried out. Do you think the timings were good enough, and you know, the track was good today?
Yeah, the track dried out very quickly. So all the laps were done in dry conditions, and it held out, as you said, the weather. Nice day, and a lot of exciting cars. All these cars are very fast on the track, and they're fun to drive, and it's a typical driver's car.
But a real surprise, you know, I mean, the car that came out ahead, so the Jag F-Type R, were you as surprised, seeing it up front?
Well, I wasn't surprised the F-Type R was the quickest today, but, it's significantly faster than its competition here. So that's a plus point. And also from the XKRS, the real compare, this new platform is, you know, much better in terms of handling, in terms of putting the power down and everything else. So.
Yeah. Because a track is not only about putting the power down, it's also about the way, you know, the car handles, the dynamics, all that comes into play in on-track timings. So, what did you think about that?
Yeah, this track is not only about top speed, there are a lot of corners here, I think 14 corners here. So, so it's as you said, it's a lot of mechanical grip also that's important to get a good lap time out of these cars.
Yeah. So which one was your absolute favorite?
Well, so I think the F-Type R, the fun factor was just incredible, and plus it's very fast on the track, and the noise, it looks very nice, and everything as a package, it was excellent, to be honest. And the Porsche, the Cayman S, a little bit underpowered to my liking, but nevertheless, very, very sweet handling car. The M6 Grand Coupe also was a lot of fun to drive. And we didn't push it too much because it's a brand new car. It's done only 100 kilometers. And then obviously the RS7 and so on. They were all good cars, as I said.
Yeah. So you've had a great time on the track. And I think we'll have to come back for another edition of Track Day with some more cars to see if we can really shatter that barrier.